Hi friends, thank you so much for stopping by. I'm Mindy Grace and this is my channel, Girl of a Different Era. And today our subject of a video is this darling little bonnet that I am wearing. This was super fun to make and I started with a straw hat, so it's a bit of a thrift flip. I've noticed that's like your favorite video is making the petticoats out of bedsheets. So I feel like people really like thrift flips and reusing things and turning them into more useful items. So I'm just hoping you guys will enjoy this one just as much. It was actually really fun and actually pretty easy to make. Once I sort of got the hang of it, I watched a bunch of helpful tutorials to sort of see the basis of doing it. And I'm actually pretty happy with how it turned out, even though there is problems. For my first adventure into millinery, I'm actually quite pleased with how it all turned out. Okay then, let's get right into my sewing. Well, I guess it's not sewing, let's get right into my gluing process. Very not historical, I know, but let's just face it, hot glue is awesome!
The first thing I started out with was this hat, which you can see in all these angles. Pretty basic, real straw, but pretty basic. The first thing I did is just take off the ribbon that was on it. There was a few stitches located around the base of it. And I just used my stitch ripper and took that off. It was actually pretty, you know, just pretty basic, pretty easy. I then really wasn't quite sure what to do next, so I decided I would try to find the center and do a small cut. Then I decided to take off the sort of inside thing that was sort of making it hold its shape. I'm not even quite sure the purpose of this band, but I think it makes the hat keep its specific shape. So anyways, I knew I wasn't going to need that, and I decided to just use my stitch ripper again and take it right off. The next thing I decided to do was just make a small cut. I had seen some videos and I didn't want to do too much at once, so I just did a basic little cut using my sort of center point as a guideline and decided I would be doing lots of trying on, which you guys won't really be seeing, but I really had this hat on and off all the time. That's when I decided I was going to also need to cut into the actual sort of crown of the hat, you might want to call it. And again, I really didn't want to take away too much at once, so it was lots of little bits, trying to smooth it, trying it on, deciding it needed more. Pretty much, yeah, that's what I was doing. Again, I had tried it on and I decided I would, you know, I was also trying to keep it even and cutting off the same amount on either side. I really can't tell you the measurements I use because I don't really know them, and every head, every face, every human's different, so trial and error, that's the key. And here I just put a little hot glue on the places where the hat was coming undone since I cut it and sort of broke the stitching in areas, obviously, so I was just sort of repairing that. So like I said, trial and error, and take it small bits at a time. If you're making a hat, just take it small and don't cut off too much at once, because you can always cut off more, but you cannot always put back on more. And I was a little unsure how to finish the edge, but I did have some leftover, I think this is a 1/4 inch double fold bias tape here. Bias binding, I should say. You know what I mean. So I just put some hot glue in the center of that and just sort of walked it along where I had cut my hat. This would provide a nice smooth edge and hopefully keep the hat from, you know, kind of losing the straw from where I cut it. Sort of like the equivalent to a hem or putting bias binding on actual garments, I guess. So that's basically what I was just doing here. And just taking it slow and a little bits at a time. Try not to burn my fingers with hot glue, which is quite possible. As you can see, I'm using the two different methods. The one's putting it on the center of the bias binding, the one's putting it on the edge of the hat. It's pretty much the same thing. And when I was done attaching it, I then went and just sort of glued down the edges because I'd really only gotten the center on. So I wanted to glue down all the edges so they would lay nice and flat, obviously. And after a little ado, I decided I would add a brown band. And yeah, I could have sewn it and flipped it inside out, but call me lazy, I just folded it in a way. I'm like, hey, I'm using hot glue, I don't want to have to stitch anything. And this is the same material I used for my dress. And I thought it would kind of help pull it together. So that was kind of fun. I was like, no stitching, right? This is really a no-sew project. It's also a very good stash-busting project if you want to make a simple bonnet, because everyone's got leftover material or lace or just little things. So really awesome as far as that goes. After I glued it on the first time, I went around again on the upper edge so all of it was going to lie nice and flat and it wouldn't be falling off or peeling off or anything like that. And now I had to figure out how I was going to finish off sort of the ends to make sure they didn't fray. Again, I could have totally stitched this and then turned it inside out, but I didn't do that. So I just curled the ends under, glued them down, and then glued them to the inside of my hat. And now, of course, it came to the pretty stuff, which I was trying not to use too much of because it's supposed to be a simple bonnet. But I found this lovely little sort of trim and I just hot glued that right over the band. It added quite a lot to it. So that was really fun. Again, I just love those little pretty things and I literally kept reminding myself, don't use too much fancy stuff because this is going with a very plain, simple dress. I then had to decide what I was going to do for the ties. And while this took me a while, I eventually did settle on using the same sort of trim and just gluing that down. So on the outside, you don't really see the bias binding, you just see this pretty little trim. It was very flexible, which I sort of needed because I'm like, I don't really want to have to. I could have made bias, you know, with brown fabric, but I just found this and I'm like, let's do this. This might be better anyways. And it did end up looking quite nice. As I was also doing this, I realized it was so stretchy and I almost wanted something stronger to actually tie it with so it wouldn't be flexible or anything. And you'll be seeing that coming up, how I glued a ribbon to it and not too hard. I just love this accidental screenshot, so. Okay, and now I found some nice ribbon, also in my stash, as I said, stash busting, right? And I just glued that right to the trim, and it was nice because it was just slightly narrower, so it wasn't really obvious, but it was still there. So when I got to the part that actually didn't need it to be flexible, like around the sort of crown area, that's when I glued on the ribbon and then glued the ribbon to the hat. And after that, after I finished gluing it, I just continued that glue strip of the ribbon to the trim all the way down till my strings reached the length I wanted them to be. I finished off my string ribbon trim by just trimming it and then gluing the ribbon down and then sort of tucking it up over the trim. I did try melting the trim because I thought it would be polyester, but it didn't really act like polyester, so hey, it'd be really cool if it was cotton, right? So I just glued that ribbon to the end of it. And now, I knew it. I knew I was gonna get crazy with the pretty stuff, but I just got this idea of putting lace around the edge because it made it look so much like a bonnet, with sort of the lace poking up over the top. So yes, I found some lace in my stash, which ended up being, it's kind of scratchy lace, so it's not very pleasant to use in like a garment where it's gonna actually be touching you. So it actually was a really good use for it. So keep that in mind if you've got some scratchy lace. Basically, I just found which of the areas I wanted to put it. I think I put it like a second row or third row in on the weave and just glued that down at the base. And then I went around again and glued it down so it wouldn't be flopping back. I wanted it to be nice and sturdy, but at the same time, not totally flat. And I was just looking it over and seeing how cute that looked and trying to decide where or if I should use any more lace. So just tried pinning this there, thinking if I really liked it or not. But I decided on doing it and I took a pencil around it and sort of marked the straight line where I wanted it to be. With the pencil, so I kind of knew what I was doing. I wasn't going to get lost in all the circles of flax or whatever they use, straw, not flax, whatever circles of straw. I don't want to get lost in them. And it was pretty much just like attaching the other lace with the hot glue and first doing the edge that you would normally attach it to the garment with, so sort of the actual edge of it, putting that on first. And I just finished it off by folding the edge under a little bit, gluing that down, and then sort of trying to hide anything that bulged out with glue. Like I said, hot glue is legit the best. Now I had to decide what I wanted to do, and I just felt like I wanted something, some other lace thing to pull it all together. And I ended up deciding, hey, I should put it on the top around this like little like straw thing that's not in a circle. I just like, hey, you know, that really might make it look like a bonnet. So that's sort of what I did, and just trying to fiddle with it till it actually fit around the top in a way that fit the shape. And again, I just did the end. I encircled the other end and used hot glue to pin it all down. And yes, a spoon does come in handy when working with hot glue or a knife or something, so you don't actually have to touch it. And I went back, actually, to make sure everything else was dry and just added a little hot glue to put the second circle of lace so it wouldn't be flopping all around. Again, this is kind of tricky because I didn't want to make it look totally flat because then it doesn't look very nice anymore, but I also wanted it to stay stuck down. One of the final things I did was add another layer of lace to that top area to make it to kind of give it the last cute effect. I just thought, hey, you know what? Like I said, I was getting carried away with lace, but I was just having such a good time. And I'm hoping this bonnet will look like, you know, because the South wasn't always poor. It was just during the war when times were hard that they became less wealthy. So people still could have rich things in their stash. to finish it off, I found more similar trim in a different package, glued it over itself to sort of form a double trim thing so it wasn't going to fray, because this type of stuff really did want to fray. So hot glued that all into one little hard thingy. Thingy is a technical term, you know. And then I just hot glued it down to the hat at the center of my little lacy poof. And yeah, I'm actually pretty happy on how that all turned out looking so cute. And here is just a nice overall look of my bonnet. And as I'm going to be using it with my sort of southern dress, I wanted it to be pretty, but at the same time, kind of show that the South was not a very rich nation at the time of the Civil War. So the ladies still wanted to be pretty, but they wanted it to be within their means.
Views, comments, they really, really mean a lot to me. And it's just really fun. So thank you so much for watching this video, and let me know if you like hat tutorials or what you'd love to see me make. I always like suggestions, and you never know, hey, I might take you up on some. So thanks again for watching, and I will see you all next time.